So, as we had already seen in previous video, that Hopfield network is example for auto-associative memory. So, today we will see how this network actually works. So, now here we have been given with four different matrices. So, this each represent an activation. So, here our first task is to decide how many number of neurons are present in this network. So, we can here see each has four elements. So in this network, the number of neurons present will be 4. Now second thing, how many connections or synapses will be present? So let's say this number is n. So synapses is given by n square minus n. So in this case, it will be 4 into 4 minus 4. So we will have 12 synapses. Now we got the idea about the network architecture. So let us see how this will work. So here our first job is to create a weight matrix and initialize all its elements to 0. So now as we have our input matrix, our input activation matrix with 4 elements, so this weight matrix will also be of 4 cross 4. Now here the diagonal values which are cross, this represents the neurons with self connections, else no other neuron will be self connected. So all the values are 0. Now the second thing, this upper triangle represents the presynaptic values and this lower triangle represent postsynaptic values. So in short, we can say the values of this lower triangle will be mirror image of values in this upper triangle. Simply saying, this W12 will be equal to W21, W13 will be equals to W31, and so on. Now this weight matrix is updated according to this equation, which is simply the multiplication of activation values in our given matrix. So let's say we have X1 activation matrix and we have to update this weight matrix according to this X1 using this equation. So let us apply this equation Wij. So first of all, W12 for this position. So W12 will be equals to activation of first neuron into activation of second neuron. So activation of first neuron is 1, second is also 1. So 1 into 1, it will be here 1. Now W12 is 1, so 21 will also be 1. In the same way, we will have all these values as 1. So our weight matrix after learning this X1 will look like this. Here is the weight matrix after learning this X1. Now it will learn X2 and update this weight matrix again. So for W12, 1 and 2 it will be minus 1. Then for 1 and 3, 1 and 3 it will be 1. 1 and 4 it will be minus 1. Now these values will be mirrored. So minus 1, 1 and minus 1. Now W2, 3, 2 and 3, so minus 1, here also minus 1, and W2, 4, it will be 1, so here also it will be 1, W3, 4, 3 into 4, it will be minus 1, so 4 and 3 also will be minus 1. Now the network has learned X1 and X2 activation matrix, so our next task will be of summing up this both matrices. So in sum we will have x0 2 0 0 x0 2 2 0 x0 0 2 0 and x. Now we got the sum matrix. So our next task will be to check the stability for X1 and X2 activation matrix. So So now the stability checking is done with the help of this given equation. The value of Wik, we have to consider this from weight matrix. This Ak will be the value from our this activation matrix for which we are going to check the stability. And this function sign, it simply means that if we obtain any value greater than 0, then it will be considered as positive 1. And if we get any value less than 0, then it will be considered as minus 1. This theta is our threshold value, which is subtracted after multiplying this both. So let's continue with our example. Now for simplicity, let's consider we have been given this threshold theta equals to 0. We have this matrix x1 and we have to check the stability for first neuron. So here our I will be equals to 1. Now let us apply this equation. So Wik, here our k will vary from 1 to 4 because we have 4 cross 4 matrix. So W 1 1 1 2 1 3 and 1 4, its values are x 0 2 and 0. Now paste all these values as it is here, 1 1 1 1. So after multiplication we will get x 0 2 and 0, and its addition will be 2. 2 is greater than 0, so this equation will output plus 1. Now this sign is compared with the value of neuron for which we are checking the stability. First neuron has also value of plus 1, which means this neuron is stable. So in the same way, for I equals to 2, 3 and 4, we will get a value greater than 0. Obviously, we will get a value of 2. So this function will output the value as plus 1. And also from here, we can see all the values are plus 1. So we can prove the stability of neurons 2, 3 and 4 likewise, or will be stable. Now in the same way, we will check the stability for each neuron of x2 matrix. So for this neuron I equals to 1, we will have this value, so it will be x 0 2 0, which will sum to 2 greater than 0, which means a positive value. Here is also a positive value, so this neuron is stable. In the same way, for I equals to 2, we will get this row, second one, so it will be 0x02. So after multiplying this with our original values 1 minus 1 1 and minus 1, we will get a sum of minus 2, which is less than 0, so it will give a negative value. And already we have a negative value in second neuron, so this neuron is also a stable one. In the same way, we can prove stability for third and fourth neurons. For third neuron, I equals to 3, it will be 2, which will output plus 1, so it is also stable. For I equals to 4, it will output minus 2, so it will be minus 1. Fourth neuron is already negative 1, so our fourth neuron is also stable 1. Now our network has already learned this both matrices x1 and x2 as well as checked for the stability of each neuron, and our next task is to learn this x3 matrix and update itself. Now for the purpose of updating, we have to focus only on the element, only on the neuron which has some value change. So from here we can easily see that from x2 and x3, x3 have the change in only third element 1 to minus 1, Now the equation for this updation has also a minor change. Our last equation had wik into ak, but here it's wik into ai. So here we were getting values row wise, but here we will get the values column wise, right? So now let us try to solve this. First of all, I am pasting all the values as it is, 1, minus 1, minus 1 and minus 1. Now there is change in this third neuron as compared to x2. So just keep here a x. Now this x is present at third position, so our k will be equals to 3. So to find the values from matrix, we have to do wik. So it will be w13, w23, w33 and w43. So let us look what are our values from this matrix. W13, 23, 33 and 43, 20x0. So here we have 20x and 0. Now multiplying this, we get 20x and 0. This will output 2. Now 2 is greater than 0. It is a positive value, so it will output plus 1. But here we can see the value of neuron containing this x is negative, which means that this neuron with value minus 1 is not stable, and this neuron will flip itself to plus 1 to become stable. In the same way, let us see for our fourth activation matrix. So 1, minus 1, 1 and 1. Now seeing this matrix, we got an idea that it is similar to our x1 with only change in second element. So just keep here an x. Now this x is present at second position, so we will have our k equals to 2. It will be of w12, 22, 32 and 42. So what are our values? Let's look at our weight matrix. 12, 22, 32 and 42, 0x, 0 and 2. So here we will have 0x, 0 and 2. This will output value. Now its sum will be 2, so it will output the value minus plus 1. Now again this value is plus 1, but the value of neuron which contain x is minus 1. So again this neuron is not stable, and this neuron will flip itself to plus 1. So like this, our hopeful network will continue learning, checking for all stabilities and updating itself.